No internet, no servers, no phone numbers. This is really good, guys, for the Doomsday Communications. Okay, we got something here, guys. Okay, guys, look at this. Okay, if you look at this. Hello, Jack Dorsey. This video also can be your external security review. Okay, Jack? Hopefully, this is useful for you too. Okay? Hello, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. Can you imagine one day there is a doomsday when the telecommunication is not really working? Your cell phone is not working. Your home telephone is also down. So this is what some people say as a terminology is the doomsday telecommunications. Okay, some of them suggest, okay, we need to have a whistle. Freet! Something like that, right? Or some of them using the handy talkie or maybe using the baofeng, the radio ham, etc. Currently, what I would like to discuss this one is actually something that we can also use it for the doomsday communications, guys. The story is the co-founder of the Twitter, the Jack Dorsey, he has some project. The name is Bitchat. Oh yeah, guys, don't forget to subscribe, switch on the bell, and please share this channel to others. Thank you so much, guys. So this is the Bitchat. I'm going to show it to you. This is the GitHub. So actually before the GitHub name is not permissionless techno. It's actually the GitHub name is like this. Jack Bitchjack and then / Bitchat. The thing that I like here is this is decentralized. So no need any server. No need some particular server like in the telecommunication. No need some particular antenna that acting as a peripheral itself. No, it's not like that. So this is really decentralized peer-to-peer crowdsource messaging app that works over Bluetooth mesh networks. So this is independently, guys. No internet, no servers, no phone numbers. This is really good, guys, for the doomsday communications, which is hopefully we don't want this is happen. You know, this crazy time at this time right now, there's a climate change. Sadly, there is some war also happen in other place, right, guys? Back again to this one, I think this is going to be some good contingency plan for if you want to have like communications doomsday, guys. Hopefully this is not happen. Or if not, there's a doomsday, we can using this as independently for communication, right, guys? So we independent from any server, from anything, guys. Okay, so back again to this one. So today we are going also to check the application itself in terms of we will try to do some passive interceptions. Imagine like this, if I'm using HTTPS and I'm sniffing HTTPS inside of my laptop or maybe in my cell phone, you won't get any, won't able to read the HTTPS because it's encrypted, right? It with the TLS 1.2 or 1.3 currently we have. So I would like to do the same thing. I'm not just only do some sniffing inside my phone. I'm going to sniffing using my phone in this case, the Bluetooth, because it's using Bluetooth. I'm also going to do passive intercept using my HackRF. So what is the method that I'm going to do? Number one, for the HackRF, I'm going to use it this one, the ICE9 Bluetooth sniffer. I will not explain this very details. If you want to have the details of this one, you just need to watch, there is one of my video explain the details how to use this particular tool, Bluetooth passive intercept. This is the thumbnail, it look like this. Also, I'm going to put in the card. And also, I'm going to put as a prerequisite video in the link of this, the descriptions of this video, guys. This is passive intercept, not connect to any cell phone. It just connect to my laptop just for the purpose of the Wireshark seeing in the real time. Although there is some buffer address, it's near real time. And number two, I'm also going to sniffing inside the Bitchat of my phone. So this is my phone. I'm going to sniffing the Bitchat here as well. But you can see also my video sniffing Bluetooth in Android. I will not tell also 120% details with this one. If you want to know the details of this one, you see also my second prerequisite video, guys. Sniffing Bluetooth in Android. So the goal is of this one, guys, we want to see if there is some particular payload that we send, we can see it at least from that one, guys, or it is really 100% 120% encrypted. Although guys, there is some already warning here. Warning, there is some like disclaimer. Private message and channel features have not received any external security review. May contain vulnerability. Hello Jack Dorsey, this video also can be your external security review. Okay Jack, hopefully this is useful for you too. Okay, external security review and may contain vulnerabilities. Okay, great, at least being humble to be declared this one. How this is installed is actually using brew. This is actually using the Mac, right? In this case, so Mac, so using the XGen, etc. But today I'm not going to using in the Mac. I'm going to use in my Android, guys. So this is the Android, the Bitchat Android, and we are going to the next page release in this case. I would like to disclaimer also, during taking this video, we still in the APK release 0.71, okay? If ever after that 0.8 or 0.9, maybe they will release to fix this one, feel free for yourself to check it. And tell me your experience, guys, okay? What you don't tell in this comment. Back again to this one. Okay, now we already just download this one, we go to this one, this is APK. And the APK already download. This is the APK itself. I will just tell you how to install this. You can send this file to WhatsApp. Install WhatsApp or through the email. Just install that one. Just make sure you allow the unknown source to be installed, guys. But after that, you enable it again. Just in case some unresponsible rat sending by Telegram, etc. is dangerous right now, guys. And okay, now I'm going to install this. Okay, already like this. Okay, we got the serial here. And then after that, install Bitchat. Okay, we perform the install now. Okay, done. We will going to open this later, guys, okay? When we want to sniffing. Okay, guys, this is finished, right, guys? The preparation finished. Okay, now we are good to go to check this one, guys. Okay, now it's our time to do the testing. Okay, the strategy to do this testing is I'm going to sending the very huge payload. So it will be make the obvious during our tracing later. So our tracing right now, we will try using the HackRF. Okay, guys, HackRF. I think I already mentioned in the previous one when I set up the HackRF. I tell you where you need to, which video that you need to refer, how to make these installations, and also which video to make Android sniffing of the Bluetooth. Okay guys, oh yeah guys, I don't using any antenna for this one because my phone is near with this Bluetooth, right? This is my phone, so I think this is sensitive enough to receive the Bluetooth itself. Okay, now guys, I'm going to running the HackRF info just to make sure that my HackRF is already plugged properly. Okay, we got it guys. Okay, so this is the HackRF, and now I'm going to open my Wireshark. We will start sniffing first from the HackRF. So this is really passive interceptions, I mean really passive, doesn't connect to any Bluetooth. It's connect to my laptop just only to share the data towards the Wireshark. Okay, now I'm going to start this. Okay, we got the error guys, must be 20. Okay, so this is the same thing like my previous video guys, you remember how I troubleshoot it. But okay, I'm just going to repeat here. So this is how I troubleshoot this. This is only capable only for 20 channel only. So there are some chance when we sending the payload, the text, the Bitchat text very huge, there is a chance that the HackRF will not capture this one, because one, the frequency of the Bluetooth keep hopping, and this is only cover 20 channel. Okay, in order to cover everything, I think 40 channel if I'm not wrong, but this is only able to cover 20 channel. Number two, if the payload very small, sometimes it's not really obvious reflected in the Wireshark. Okay, I'm going just push through now. Let's move now. Okay. Okay, we have a lot of things here. Now we are going to open this. Where is it? Okay, this is my Chromecast. Okay, this is the Bitchat itself. Okay, it's analyze. And then of course, okay, this is already connected to my other Android. Okay, guys, which is this one. So we are going to passive intercept now through the HackRF. Okay. Look at this. We got something, guys. Let me check. So we need just to BT attribute dot value. Where is a BT attribute? Dot value. Okay, we got something here, guys. Okay. Okay, guys, look at this. Okay, if you look at this one, this is the message that fragmented. But actually, guys, this is something that mean we can read, right, guys? I mean, this is not really 100% encrypted. Even I'm not yet, because it's sniffing in the Android itself. Okay, I'm doing this one again. Let me do it again. Boom. Okay, guys, if you want to help me, you can feel free to treat me 1 cup, 2 cups, 3 cups. I'm so happy if you want to treat me that one. 100 cups, 1000 cups. I'm so happy, guys. You just need to follow this QR code. This one. This one. Or I'm going to... Those QR code will redirect you to the link. Or I'm just going to give you also the link in the link description of this video, guys. Okay, guys? Thank you very much. Okay, look at this one, guys. Okay? See? This. This one, the amount, the mass to add mod list, is the huge payload that I put it chatted here, guys. Okay, let you use this one, okay? So this is mass object. You look at this one, right? I put the payload is from the RRC of the LTR 5G. I think the new the 5G in this case. Rather, regardless is 5G SA or NSA. But doesn't matter, guys. I mean, this... You can look at this one, right, guys? Report amount, mass to airport. This is actually came from this one. That means we still can able to read this one, right, guys? That means we still able to read this. Even I'm not yet sniffing this from my Bluetooth in this case, okay? So let's make it double, guys. Let us also sniffing from... I will just enable this one, sometimes this is quite buggy also, right, guys? Sometimes after I export the ADB, etc., is still sometimes there is a Bluetooth snoop, sometimes there is not, but no problem, we will do it repeatedly, guys, until we get both of the... I mean, the most important now, we want to see directly from the ADB itself. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going go to switch off this, disable again, this one. I will disable this. Okay, this is already disabled. I will just make directory check BT, and then go to check BT in this case, and then I'm going to running this command ADB back. Report one, let's say. Okay. Oh, what happened? ADB devices. What I'm gonna do, guys, I'm going to switch off this the Wi-Fi, because it's conflicting with this ADB. So I think you already seen this enough, right, guys? Okay. So we will just disconnect this. I will just unplug this. ADB disconnect everything. Okay, then I will attach this one. Okay, then I'm going to running one more. Let me check. Okay, run. Okay, still generating. Sometimes, guys, I don't know why, sometimes also the BT snoop is not there. So our expectation now, right, guys, if we sniffing the HTTPS in our laptop or even in our mobile phone, still, because of the TLS 1.3 or 1.2, we still cannot see the HTTP itself unless we have an official certificate to encrypt that one, right, guys? So that means for the HTTPS, even in our own interface, we still cannot see it. But Before move further to this Android, you can still see it from the HackRF. Even we can still some fragmented readable for what is the text is being sending in this case. Although it's not all right, guys, but still is quite scary in my thinking, right, guys? Something that need to be addressed to close that kind of that gap. Okay, guys, this is quite takes times this bug report. Aha, okay, we got something. Hopefully there is a Bluetooth, guys. No. Okay, hopefully. Okay. Okay, we got Bluetooth, guys, from here. That's great. Okay, this is the logs that we want to see it, guys. This is great. So we need to open this .log with Wireshark. I know this is .pickup. Why? You just watch my video about the one that I mentioned it in this opening of this video. Okay, I will stop this one. Okay, see this one, guys. Okay, look at this one, see. So okay, this is the one that I told you, right? Also, this is we can see directly from this one. So this is the payload. You can see report configuration, add mode, etc. So this message, even we still can sniff it in the Android. Actually, if in the Android we can see this one, I'm no longer surprised anymore, because even in the HackRF passive doesn't connect to anything. Doesn't connect to any associated this Bluetooth. We still can see those messages is able to do to be the intercept in the passive way in this case, guys. So you look at from this one, guys. Okay, see. This is the message that I send it. Report config trigger type event ID etc. So is this the part of the disclaimer warning that already said by in the GitHub of the Jack Dorsey, in the GitHub of the Bitchat itself? This software has an original. Okay, this is hopefully can be part of this external review, external security review, and make the one that already declared this one, guys. Okay, guys, what do you think, guys? I want to know your comment. Please write the comment here. What I want to know your opinion. What we should do to report and to make the Jack Dorsey aware about this one, guys? Or also, is this good enough for the Doomsday Telecommunications alternative rather than we buy another amateur video or we buy another bafong or another handy talkie walkie talkie etc. What do you think, guys? Okay, guys, as I always say in my other previous video, keep learning and stay humble.